This is the Travis and Steven Show. Steven Show.
Travis Show.
You're such an asshole. Productions sixth video log numero six. Thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Steven.
Travis, about time we make a sixth video.
My fault. I am a dick. Yeah. Apparently.
And say dick is.
I'm a douchebag. I'm a faggot. Yeah. I'm a loser. I'm an alcoholic. I'm a workaholic. Whatever you want to call it.
No, he's just too cool. You're just too cool. I'm just gonna not make a sixth video.
I work 40 hours a week. I fall asleep at 3:30 till like 7:30. So I apologize. In this movie, we're going to talk about The Dark Knight, which I'm not going to do any reviews on because you can search for any kind of review you want. There's pretty much 100,000 out there.
Yeah.
I saw Step Brothers. I won't spoil anything. Got two douchebags, and then one cranky old bitch.
And then an astronaut.
And so we're going to talk about that. So first, let's start out with our movie review. Obviously.
Batman The Dark Knight.
Dark Knight. Which is, you know,
a
just
lot.
Offhand. You like haven't seen this movie.
Oh, my mom, my dad?
I know, it's like 6 and 7 now.
Okay.
So you guys are douchebags, you need to go see this movie.
My sister Miguel.
Still go freaking 45 minutes, go before,
you know, it's go bullshit. The theaters are still being sold out. Yeah. That's how good the movie is. I had to see it twice.
Yeah. So it's a 3-hour movie. Take a piss before the trailers come on. There's a trailer for Watchmen. There's a trailer
for the new Terminator.
There's a the newest Spirit trailer is out. The new Twilight was in there too. It's a book.
I know.
Those
four.
The
world, just, the
just
world stood still.
And the world stood still too. Another one. Five good movies. If Heath Ledger's didn't die, do you think he would still this The Dark Knight have that much success? What do you think?
I think so. I don't think kind of thing, you know? If you saw it, you'd know what I'm talking about.
So, yeah.
So.
But that's it. Dark Knight. Go see it. The whole world blows up in the movie. There's no
you
other
die.
Way. There's no other.
Not Batman. You die.
Batman lives. Anyways. I saw Step Brothers while he saw
Batman again.
Yeah, The Dark Knight.
Sorry, Jason wanted to see anything.
I saw Step Brothers.
How was that?
It was an amazing movie. If you like Will Ferrell comedy, then go see it. I don't like Will Ferrell comedy. Personally,
racist.
I hated Talladega Nights. I hated Blades of Glory.
You hated Blades of Glory? I
hated that movie.
Ooh, it was awesome.
It's a pro.
I've never seen it, so.
I know. Well,
like 5 minutes.
Yeah, the first like 20 minutes we saw sucked. What other movies?
Stranger to the Fiction,
but that's not really Will Ferrell comedy. You know Will Ferrell comedy. If you like it, go see it. If you don't, I recommend going seeing it. It was really funny. The storyline was pretty good. The plot was okay. The, you know, Will Ferrell and the other guy. But Will Ferrell did a good job, and I think it's a really good movie, so you should definitely go see it.
Okay. Former NASA astronaut and moonwalker Dr. Edgar Mitchell, a veteran of the Apollo 14th mission, says extraterrestrials has visited Earth on several occasions, but the government is covering it up for 6 decades. And I guess he claims that the aliens are small and gray. 77 years old. I don't know. He might be senile, but he might also be onto something.
He's probably still alive.
Have you been in the moon?
Moonwalking.
Have you been in the moon? Have you been in the moon?
No.
Okay, then shut up. Aliens exist.
Okay, cool.
Do you guys think aliens exist?
I don't believe so.
Our universe is a grain of sand in a sandbox. The sandbox is like this big, and the grain of sand is like this big. So it's like that big.
That was an amazing story, Travis.
I thought it was pretty cool. He's just old and like, oh, no, no.
I'm telling you, he's still moonwalking. He's crazy.
Try to think about you, okay?
Don't you do that. So say that your microwave breaks and you go outside and you try to clean it and try to take it apart. If you get mad at it, don't shoot it. But apparently, a guy in Milwaukee decided to do that. So Keith Walodensky, 56-year-old man, decided to shoot his lawnmower after it wouldn't work. After he tried to start it, it wouldn't work. He was charged with possession of a shotgun and disorderly conduct while armed. What?
It's just funny because he's old and he's...
You didn't shooting. Like it. You didn't like it when I first said it.
Well, I thought it was stupid, but the whole wielding shotgun 56-year-old was pretty cool. Yeah, but like, people think that the whole reason he got arrested because he shot his lawnmower. He got arrested for having a gun outside shooting it.
And a statement that he later made, I can do that. It's my lawnmower and my yard, so I can shoot it if I want. So, good job, dude. You, sir, are a faggot. So, once again, if you're trying to fix something, don't take it outside and shoot it. Just my personal thought. So, say that you're going to rob a department store. Don't do it and then leave a trail to your exact location, because apparently that's what Kyle and Alan did. In Monroe, Washington, both Kyle Burris, 25 years old, and Alan Pierce, 27 years old, robbed a department store for pillows and hammocks. They are charged with second-degree burglary, and obviously this picture shows that they are complete dumbasses. They led a trail of cardboard, plastic, and pillows and backpacks to their exact location, and then cops took this picture right before waking them up. They were charged with second-degree burglary, like I said, and one was found sleeping in a hammock, and the other was found sleeping on a bunch of pillows. And then the police put out a statement saying that alcohol was involved. So if you're going to rob a department store or whatever you're going to rob,
drunk,
don't do it and then leave a trail that leads right to you.
Well, you can, just don't do it under the influence because you'll...
Then you're a dumbass.
Yeah, because you'll
be like... I nominate that the douchebag of the week. Two douchebags of the week. Way to go. Now you're on $6,000 or $11,000 bail. And good job. You're the greatest. Dumbass.
About to get a shout out. My friend Stephanie. Hello.
Hi.
I'm going to think of a random person.
Jason Cassone. He's passed out drunk on my couch right now. Or he'd be here saying hello.
Nick Smith is a terrorist.
Yeah. Boom. Hey, Nick Smith's a terrorist. Owned.
Ryan's secret.
Sucks to be that guy.
I heard Derek Jacobs watched their videos.
What did it know?
Is it Evil 6-1 Productions signing off?
Already? No! I don't want to leave. Our fans like us.
We don't have any fans.
Oh, that's true.
Fuck you. Alright. I just want to end.
Add us with a MySpace now. www.myspace.com/Evil 6-1 Productions. If you want to just, you know.
This must be your trust.
Yeah, bitch, MySpace. And all you little fairies out there, MySpace it up.